Good morning to all participants in online interdisciplinary 1 week certificate course on apiculture. Today is the fifth day of our course. The today's module is module number 8, and for that purpose we invite to Professor Dr. P.S. Salunkhe sir. Firstly, I heartily welcome to Professor Dr. P.S. Salunkhe sir. I requesting to sir for delivering his lecture on application of honey. Thank you very much, sir.
Myself, Dr. P.S. Salunkhe, Professor and Head, Department of Zoology, Balavant College, Meta. At the outset, I welcome you all on the occasion of online interdisciplinary 1 week certificate course on apiculture. Respected principal of this college, Dr. Khilare, coordinator, organizer, resource persons and delegates who are attending this course on apiculture. Respected friends, the topic allotted to me is application of honey. Friends, my topic is consists of application of honey in medicine, application in food products, and in potential health effects. Dear friends, when we see the role of honey in medicine, especially antimicrobial activity, that activity is due to presence of low pH, high sugar, methyl glycosyl, basilomycin, then malat products, then methylic extracts, aromatic acids, glycoproteins like 10-HAD, defensin-1 and MRGP-1. Friends, when we see the another property of the honey, especially antiviral and antifungal activity, antiviral activity is due to presence of methyl glycosyl, while antifungal activity is due to presence of the flavonoid and basilomycin. Here I will add here that honey is especially inhibiting the growth of rubella virus and herpes virus. Honey has a fungicidal activity against the dermatophytes. Honey is also effective against candida and penicillium at the concentration of higher than 10%. So these are the two properties of the honey, especially antiviral and antifungal activities. When we see the another activity, antioxidative activity, that activity is because of presence of glucose oxidase, catalase, ascorbic acid, flavonoids, phenolic acid, carotenoids, derivatives, organic acid, malar reaction products, amino acids and proteins. Honey works synergetically with herbs. Antioxidant capacity of the honey decreases by 30% on the 6 months of the storage. But when we see the storage temperature of the storage, it having no effect on the antioxidant activity of the capacity of the honey. When we see the other functional properties of the honey, then these are the different properties of the honey and their principal components. Anti-inflammatory activity, it is because of the flavonoid, phenolic acid and due to the oxidative and antimicrobial effects. Anti-mutagenic or anti-tumor activity, that activities are due to presence of chemferol, then curacetin, the antioxidant properties and HMF. Immunomodulated or immunoprotective or immunoactivating activity of the honey is due to presence of nigerose, alpha-albumin 1 and antimicrobial effect. Herpetoprotective effect of the honey is due to presence of antioxidative activity. Radioprotective effect of the honey is due to antioxidant and anti-inflammatory effect. Anti-atherogenic activity of the honey is due to presence of hydrogen peroxide, that is H2O2, and flavonoids and antioxidant activities. So these are different properties of the honey which are responsible for these different properties. When we see the role of the honey in the healing of the wound, you see here the painful and the infection wound on the left leg here. The fracture was stabilized with the plates and screws. Here after 5 days of the treatment to the wound by the honey, it is found that this wound condition was significantly improved and new tissues were built and the bacterial inflammation and diminishing significantly. When we see after about 2 months, the wound is totally completely closed. So here you found that honey having very much good role in the healing of the wounds. When we see the honey product, these are the two main honey products, especially honey powder and lemon of the honey. When we see the process of production of the honey powder, the honey is taken and is mixed with wax starch, and by this diluting this process, that honey powder is produced and which can be durable. Another procedure of the production of the honey spread, here also honey is used for the production of the honey spreads, and it is also used for a longer time. These are the application of the honey in dairy. When we see the application of honey in dairy and food products, there are number of products where honey is used. You see here, these are the different dairy products. That is liquid milks, then yogurts, then lassi, then puddings, then ice creams, then camel milk ice creams, then different ice creams of the creams here. The percentage of the honey is used here. You see the percentage and what is the purpose. Especially the here honey is used for the sweetness as well as a natural preservative as well as the prebiotic ingredient. These different products, mainly honey is used for the sweetness. That means it may add the sweetness of the product. Then honey in lassi. Sharma prepared lassi by fermenting milk with the help of these two bacteria, Streptococcus thermophilus and probiotic culture of Lactobacillus helveticus. He found that with this corporation of the honey up to the 5% level, he sees quite increase in these two bacteria. Then honey in other food products. These are the different food products where honey is specially used. These are the breads, then biscuits, then cookies and muffins. All these products of the bakery products, generally honey is used at different product percentage, and that honey is used for especially for alternative sweeteners or the sugar replacement or functional ingredients or the flavor ingredients. So honey is very much useful in the bakery products. Then honey in beverage. The beverage is the main component where honey is used in different percentage, especially nutraceutical drinks, then traditional bookies or probiotic beverage or the meats or shakes or quash, wines and traditional curries. All these products where honey is used at the different percentage, and this purpose is basically addition of the sweetness. That means it increases the sweetness of these different products of the beverages. Then in honey is allergy. One of the important point I will is like to discuss here, that though this honey is very useful, this honey is also allergy to some of the human beings, and thus instances of the honey allergy is reported in the group of 173 food allergies patients was only 2.3%. But when we see this allergy, it is due to presence of honey components of the bee origin or by dandelion and compositive pollens. So these are the pollens which are responsible for the allergic activity of the honey. The allergic reported can be involved reaction varying from the cup to the anaphylaxis. Patients which are allergic to the honey are especially due to the presence of the pollen grain in the honey. When we see the health hazard of the honey, then the toxic component present in the honey are mainly hazardous to some of the human beings. And these few plants which produce the nectar contain the toxic substances. Such honeys are always hazardous to the mankind. Plants of this Ericaceae family belonging to the subfamily Rhododendron, and for example Rhododendron ponticum, contains toxic components and the honey known as a mad honey. These toxic substances includes diterpenoid and the pyrazolidine alkaloids. These alkaloids, especially polyhydroxylated cyclic hydrocarbons, these components are always hazardous to the human being. Ingestion of this type of the honey causes different symptoms, especially dizziness, vomiting, sweating, weakness, then vision is also decreases, then also loss of the consciousness, then extremely paresthesia, and excessive salivation. These are the different symptoms caused due to the ingestion of this hazardous honey. When we see the health claims for the honey, then these are the different health claims of the honey, especially diet related cardiovascular diseases, bone health and the osteoporosis, physical performance and the fitness, body weight regulation, insulin sensitive and diabetes risk, diet related cardiovascular diseases, then diet related cancer, then mental state and the performance, gut health, digestion and immunity. So these are the role of the honey in different activities. When you see the quantity and time of the honey ingestion, how much quantity of the honey and at what time you ingest this, it is also very important. The health enhancing effect in the human adult were mostly achieving after ingestion of the 50 to 80 gram of the honey per day. But when we see the health claim of the honey are valid for the intake of 50 to 80 gram per day by the adult, or for in general adult to infant, the intake of 0.8 gram to 1.2 gram honey per day per gram of the human weight is very good. The health effect were major mostly after 2 to 3 weeks of the daily honey ingestion. So these are the different companies who are mainly involved in the production of the honey or selling of the honey. You see here, this is the Dabur honey, then Easy Max honey, the Himalaya honey, then Khadi Gram Udyog honey, Nature Pure honey, then Organica, and especially all of you knowing that the Patanjali honey. Thank you very much.